In this thread, interesting ideas for your campaign, but from porn.
Why is TG like this?
Why?
Why are you guys like this? Well, what is wrong with you? Look, let's just do this woman.
A broken coomer is right twice a day. I make my centaurs like this, but less tentacle monsters and more parasite. Some people fear them as demons that turn their loved ones into helpless puppets that grant the parasite intelligence. Others have mastered a symbiosis with them, where the parasite and the human's will are eventually balanced. The latter were the horse nomads of the campaign, threatening civilized society like Genghis Khan. One of my players actually played one. It was pretty cool. One advantage compared to playing a normal centaur is that if the horse part dies, you can still climb out. On the other hand, you can't do that as easily while it's still alive, as it requires extensive reagents to pull a parasite to sleep, giving you about half a day of free time. You can tell if a centaur is rich by the quality of their leg muscles. Non-atrophied ones mean they have the money to leave their other half, at least semi-regularly. What?
I honestly have no words for that. Like, I mean, it's a cool idea. Okay, look, who here isn't a big fan of the Alien franchise? But come on, guys.
I actually thought you were about to say who here isn't a big fan of hentai. I thought that was going to come out of your mouth.
I think there's a lot of people here that are just in denial when it comes to the whole hentai. Let's be serious, guys. But I guess kind of like Alien.
Confirmed.
Castbusters. I enjoy biology and I like seeing new and interesting ways of playing about with it. And
mm-hmm.
I suppose it's cool if I didn't know finally what it's from. Yeah. What are your thoughts on this? Let's just delve into this thread and see where it goes.
Yeah. I can't remember the name, but there was this H manga that was basically just this one scientist with a zombie girl he kept stitching together and reforming her body to be covered in erogenous zones. Let's hope this isn't where the idea of Sally from Nightmare Before Christmas came from.
Yeah, it does actually. Yeah, it is Nightmare Before Christmas.
And other odd human implements. And he regularly used her to sexually both restrict and
placate
a female vampire that was regularly lurking about the area looking for blood, which led to a lot of sex and other stuff. I ran a campaign about... I ran a campaign about rescuing a cute revenant girl who was reanimated by a particular potent lich to act as their slave, but slinked off just a bit too far and started enjoying their freedom. She was marked by having a highly modular body.
I wonder how modular we talking here.
And the party had assisted her by attaching the lower body of a dead giant lizard and a pair of fuzzy gnoll arms to replace her hideously damaged and spindly regular arms. And when they finally killed the lich and granted her the true freedom to wander the earth, the first thing they did was go clothes shopping as we closed out the campaign. I pretended it was based on Zombieland Saga.
I actually kind of like that, to be honest with you. I do like the idea of like a, you know, like an NPC, and I do like the idea of just being able to like, come on, we'll slap some stuff to them.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Oh, yeah, you want new arms? We need new arms. Like, you got new arms. You want some fucking horse eggs? There you go. It's kind of sad where it came from, but I do like this, honestly. I think it's kind of cool.
Yeah.
And I do like the concept. I would love to see this, but
I won't.
I feel like it's tainted.
I feel like it's tainted because
I feel like everything in this thread is going to be tainted because I feel like we are going to come across more of these. Like, oh no, that's actually really cool. I like that idea. And then,
but we know where it came from.
Yeah. And that kind of where it all falls short.
Made a quest where an alchemist sought out ant ector from a hive and asked you to acquire a female specimen. Acquire a female specimen from the hive that had been making a deal with the surface dwellers, where in exchange for the woman enjoying biological immortality, they would become surrogate mothers inside the hive, and given ant semen that extends their life to beyond the normal human lifespan. And only death by childbirth or nectar deprivation, as the hive also sustains them. Of course, if people find out the milk from one of the surrogates can provide them with eternal life, so long they give birth to more ants, they would hunt down these hives and force the ants to slave labour, and having a breeding pen of these women with it. And then there is an ethical issue of bringing a woman who had outlived her children.
Why? Why are we doing this thread, Megan?
I don't know.
I thought it was going to kind of be a bit funny, but...
I don't know. Next post.
Next post. I am somewhat amazed, but I'm more disappointed. And I think that's what I feel. Just
I'm always
disappointment.
Disappointed when I read TG most of the time. We're in TG, so of course, it's a homebrew version of the standard D&D setting. With one exception. The ancient kingdom of the giants was never destroyed and has flourished into a vast globe-spanning empire. Society is divided into two castes, giants and non-giants. Non-giants are considered inherently inferior to giants and may automatically be considered serfs/slaves, depending on which part of the empire they're in. They are essentially thought of as lower, 8th rank of the Ordnung.
That's some giant name in them, Ordnung.
One with no god, or an inferior god to the wretch. The party are rogues/criminals/revolutionaries who are on a mission to overthrow the giant empire.
Honestly, makes sense, because I've always wondered about this when it comes to like fantasy settings. If giants, like, you know, the only thing that really stops giants is how little there are of them. Mm-hmm. Like, there's not many of them. But, like, see, let's be serious. Like, you know, if there's big enough tribes of giants, mm-hmm. what chance does any other civilization have?
Absolutely none.
I just don't see it, unless they're incredibly stupid. But see, even if you give them, like, average intelligence...
Oh, they're so dangerous.
They're just going to fuck your day up.
Yeah.
I actually just realised what that's about.
What?
The whole thing with giants.
What?
It's like Amazon porn or some shit. That's what it is. Pay you any money. Ideas from porn that would work. It's like some femdom fucking Amazon shit going on.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
Or for a more anime one. The party are all noble women suitors for a young prince. He happens to be their heir to not one, but two great empires. Upon his ascension to the throne, the prince will inherit both and become leader of the world's greatest superpower. The noble women are trying to marry him so that their faction/minor kingdoms are de facto allies of this superpower. They have to win the prince's favour while also protecting him from factions that don't want the two empires to merge, including hardliners from each of the empires, who have warned against each other on numerous occasions.
Also, I don't think that's very anime. That gives me more like Chinese dynasty vibes. Because, like, you know, like, we've all heard the stories about how dangerous them harems were. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, with the emperors and all that. And, like, you know, eventually, because quite a few of them actually did become empresses and all, like, managed to get in the door. Mm-hmm. It's very interesting stuff. So it is, if you're ever interested in Chinese history, I think it was Qing.
I find it quite hard to pinpoint, like, the porn aspect in that.
Oh, yeah, they're just going to suck his dick, pretty much. That's all I imagine.
Oh, so it's not like Cinderella with a glass slipper?
No, maybe Cinderella with a
burst. Who can take the balls, too?
Yeah, who dreams the prince's balls the best? That's a real question. And, of course, you got to put in the underage angle just to make it anime. Jesus Christ, why is anime like this?
Hey, guys, so are you looking to spice up your game night? Do you need some orcs to raid your camp? Do you need some illithids to suck out your brains? Do you need some undead to rise from the graves? What about a dragon to slap down in the table and fuck up your players with? Or if you prefer a frost giant or a manticore, we got 'em. It's a lot more fun than dropping rocks in your players' heads. Or maybe you just want short stacks. Cause we know you love them. We have such an expansive range of fantasy options, and we're currently trying to expand into not 40k. Also, if models isn't your thing, go check out our subclasses. There's loads of stuff there that you might find interesting. But go ahead and check it out. Links are all down below, and let's get back into the video. I have some ideas, but it isn't a porn comic. It's just some world building, in quotations, for my Kummer fantasies. This one is a space opera. One big space civilization wanted to terraform a bunch of planets, but it's very difficult to make a planet livable for humans. They decide to meet halfway and try to make the people able to adapt to the terraformed planets. Gene editing isn't easy and evolution takes too long. Thus, people were given two types of nanites. One, a type of organic self-replicating nanomachines that work like an extra set of genetic instructions. Two, a non-replicating set of nanomachines that make changes to the programming of the first type of nanites. The second type needs to be injected. The first type can be passed down via generations, like genes. The point is to gradually make each generation more able to live in a specific environment without special assistance. Similar to the Foundation series, the Empire fell and the space colonies inevitably lose their technology, either by lack of expertise or infighting. In the end, there are various planets of humanoid species that can breed with each other and speak a similar language. What is so Kummer about that? It is an inter-universe explanations for fur people.
I was thinking that was... It feels like a very long way around to just have, oh yeah, you know what, I want to fuck some bitch with green skin.
Yeah.
That's what I was feeling.
It is an inter-universe explanations for fur people and how they're made up of various species.
I mean, like, at least he's put in fucking effort to explain it, to explain, oh, no, there's a natural reason why these things exist. No, don't trust me, guys. No, it's in the lore, it's written down, it's in the lore, trust me, guys, it's got nothing to do with Kummer. It's just, look, if I want fucking fox girls suck my cock, I can have fox girls suck my cock, but I'm going to feel bad about it if I can't have, like, you know, a good
explanation for
why they exist, you know?
In my campaign, I wanted to add a race of fey people just to spice shit up in my medieval setting, and also give opportunity for strange magic plot hooks that might come along with that. The fey's appearances would be based on butterflies as a normal for that kind of thing. But when I tried to find an image, the only one I could find that wasn't obviously some lewd image I got off Dan Burrow was, I don't want to know what that is.
I don't want to know what Dan Burrow is. Honestly, like, all I'm imagining is, you know that song, Be My Butterfly, Sugar, Baby. Can we not just have the fae, like, you know, with that horrible fucking
spy terror
with the nautical stars, like, you know, that late 90s.
The wallet chains.
Yes.
Jenko jeans.
Yeah,
yes.
Exactly. Oh, can we not have Faye look like that?
I used Mashiro's likeness for an NPC who goes by Mother Monarch and whom my players, out of character, eloquently refer to as Moth Mummy.
Why are moths such a big thing when it comes to waifus?
I don't know.
I feel like I've missed this out. It feels like it just came about in the past year or so.
Moths.
And I don't get it.
I don't know. Her sister was made to succumb to a curse centuries ago, and she briefly experienced love for a human before he was killed. Now she is the current de facto queen of the Fae.
I prefer my version personally.
Yeah, I prefer your version.
I prefer my version where we're gonna have
you just walk into the forest and they're doing the music video.
Yeah, they're doing all the dance moves and
lady,
shit.
You got my baby. Lady.
Be my sugar. All Megan singing, so I can't.
Be my butterfly. Sugar
baby. Yeah, exactly.
I have a race of tree-dwelling insectoids that produce honey, which, when consumed, allows other creatures to be ultra-empaths with other honey imbibers.
Imbibers? No idea what
heard that word before.
Don't know what that is. I like this idea, actually, because I do think when it comes to insects, like, you know, the little hive brain and shit like that, and I think they do work on more, like, pheromones and all that, that actually is a kind of cool idea to implement.
To the point of long-distance telepathy if a lot is consumed. If you eat enough honey for long enough, you and other bugs can even intimately feel one another's emotions and sensations. All the players think it's cool. I'll never have the heart to tell them it's 100% fetish feel. What is it with all these people being attracted to insects?
I can almost understand when it comes to, like, mammals. Because at least mammals...
Shut your dirty goddamn mouth.
But mammals aren't that different, you know what I mean? But fucking insects, man. Like, what...
Fucking insects, man.
I don't get
what do you want to do? Fucking stick insects?
Honestly, you know, all I can think about is the fly. Jeff Goldblum. That's all I can think of.
Oh, yeah.
Do you reckon there's
degenerates?
I don't know.
Man, I thought we only had furries to fucking deal with.
Yeah, I think the insect
fucking degenerates. I wish I didn't know what the internet was about.
Yeah.
I was helping create a high-tech, low-culture setting. Me, whenever I'm sitting in front of my fucking computer. Magic only worked as the justification for having genetic engineering alongside a feudal system without any evident consequences. I wanted to create a female-only superpower so it could be the backbone of a de facto matriarchal empire that historically had been egregiously male-centric. Decide to give them biosuits that are grown within the womb of virgin females that deploy through conception that look like pick related.
I'm not showing pick related, guys.
I haven't seen pick related. Hold on, let me just see it. Oh yeah, no, we're not showing that.
Yeah, we're not, no.
Nope. Tentacle theme and all, since I intend them to be a pseudo-British / Greek empire with a strong navy, in control of an archipelago with the suits being reason for their dominance. Also made them look pregnant when the suit was retracted. Massive turn on for me. An interesting world-building concept.
You know what? I'll give these guys at least a wee bit of credit for, like, you know, okay, so this is what they're into.
But we gotta
work out the ins and outs, because, like, you know, like, I gotta make it at least realistic on my point of view, you know what I mean?
Are you going to kill an expecting mother immigrating due to the growing conflict in the peninsula, or a walking bee weapons of mass destruction infiltrating enemy lines? Once one of the players fucked with a noble house by giving them a Chadsburg jawline as retribution for squealing us to the aforementioned empire, since we stole a pure strain that could have been worked into different patterns of biosets.
I don't think I'm ever going to understand this shit.
I don't understand pregnancy fetishes.
No, I don't get them either.
Yeah, I know you don't get them. You have to fucking deal with me. Moaning all the time.
Yeah. Look, all I'm saying is, I appreciate that they're going out of the way to be like, you know what, this shit's good and all, like, you know, yeah, I can jack to this. However, to, like, you know, amp that shit up, I'm gonna go in, right? I'm gonna give it all backstory. I'm gonna make it look believable, and then I'm gonna make my players enjoy it, and they're not gonna know it.
And they're
fucking
gonna
better.
Honestly,
this is actually almost better for Kimmer, because at least, like, you know, you're going undercover.
They're not forcing people.
Yeah, exactly. You're not even any the wiser.
Yeah.
I wonder how many times this has happened
but
to me.
But is that worse?
Has this happened to me before? Am I a victim of this?
Are you playing a Kimmer fantasy and not knowing?
Is everything a Kimmer fantasy that we just don't know?
From childline down below.
Maybe it was the Kimmers we find along the way. Look, guys, I don't know. I think that's where we're going to end it.
Yeah.
It's a really bizarre question. It's a really bizarre idea. I feel like...
I'm nearly scared of asking the question, you guys. What would you do?
I feel like... You know what I feel like? I feel like normally it's done the reverse way. Normally it's, okay, you create your campaign, and then within your campaign you have sections that you can do. It's not that you create the fetish first and then work back. It feels like this is like a backwards way of doing
yeah.
it. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And I don't know, I just don't get you motherfuckers, to be honest with you.
I don't get I'm fucking lost.
You know what, I'm gonna go, we're gonna do something nice for next thread.
Yeah, we're gonna do something fucking nice. I don't wanna hear none of y'all Kimmers
out there. I wanna do like a couple videos back to back, no Kimmers, right?
Yeah.
I feel like I'm drowning in little
cum.
Metaphorical cum at this point, and I need room to breathe outside of the metaphorical cum. So what do you guys make of this? As I said, I think this is working backwards, and this
yeah.
is really the way. Okay, if you're going to create like a fetish, I feel like you work it the other way, not this way.
Not the opposite way.
Yeah.
Yeah, but let us know down below, and while you're down there, check out all the links to the models, the subclasses, t-shirts, all that good shit. Hit subscribe, hit the notification bell as well so you get notified every time we post a video, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye!